Welcome to a special Halloween edition of Headbangers Ball. Oh, it's probably one of those horrible little children. Ah, Dave Mustaine from Megadeth. One of my best pals. You get one of my... I have something better than candy for you. This goes with the song. What's the most shocking thing that's ever happened to you?
Well, last year, you put me in the electric chair for Halloween. This year, I got a straitjacket on. What next, the guillotine?
$20. The next guy that gets a script. A strike between me and you. A strike.
He's coming. It's back. It would not go away.
He doesn't like to be touched.
Hey, wait, let me ask you this one question. What's the worst question you've been asked in this past year that I've been getting for a year and a half?
You know the one. It's like,
how
come you look so much like Eddie Munster?
What did happen to your foot?
Just playing basketball. I broke it. But I'd like to take this moment to capture Maynard on film. I want to remember this moment always, when the moment that he was on Headbangers Ball.
You look completely shocked. Like, that was a big Kodak moment for you.
It's the first time my picture's ever been taken. I used to go to high school with Tom. He used to beat me up.
So it's kind of fun. You guys are back and beating him up once again during shows.
We were the same weight in wrestling class, and so I got to hammer him every day as our sticky bodies rubbed together in a violent fashion.
Now, in the shows, what is the order of shows? You guys go on.
We play first.
And then you play?
They open for us.
We are Judas Priest, your heavy metal host for tonight's edition of the Headbangers Ball.
If anybody out there wonders why we're here, we don't really know.
And talking of home video cassettes... Thank you, dude. It's here. It's here. Live, in person, being held by these little sweaty, heavy...
Our current video, in conjunction with our current live album. Very good value for money. You get inside a free guitar, 100-watt stack.
There's extra tracks on this, actually, folks. They're not on the double live album. We can't tell you what they are. You'll have to buy it to find out.
And you'll have to believe it.
It's a money ploy.
Lane Staley, lead vocalist of Alice in Chains, going quite fast as we go into video number one. Watch. Tell me, this kind of looks a little bit, does it look a little bit scary?
Well, I'm not really worried about the whole thing. I want to hurt you everything that I own, which is about $50.
What he said was, yeah, it looks scary. What did you think about the speed slide?
I'm feeling kind of juicy right now.
it puts more fluids through your system. I'm trying to think of a nice way to say it. What would you say?
I'd say my fig is puckered.
We got hired to be the bad boys. And we were the bad boys, and now all of a sudden we have to be businessmen and
you can
respectable
only,
and good and stuff like that.
You can only be bad boys during non-working hours.
Yeah, I'm psychotic. Something always happens at the end of a show for me, for some reason. I don't know why. It's like the last song, something happens. You can see on the live MTV thing, it's like, you know, everything was pro except this monitor man that didn't have a clue of what was going on. The crowd's hearing the show, everything's great. We're hearing spaceships land on stage, backwards echoes.
I know, it's like, what's that?
Screaming
what's
feedback,
that?
You know, the drummer doesn't know what, Steven doesn't know what's going on, you know. Finally, I tried to nail the monitor man with my microphone, and my tour manager moved and I nailed him.
Lita Ford is here. There are a lot of girls out there that are trying to put bands together, and you always hear stories about, you know, they have a hard time getting respect. Yeah. Are there any tips that you'd like to give to the aspiring female musician?
Well, I don't think it's just a woman thing. I mean, I think there's a lot of bands out there that don't have respect. You know, there's a lot of guy bands out there that don't really have a lot of respect either. You know, because of the glam thing, or maybe somebody wears too much makeup, or maybe somebody has on something that's a little risque or whatever. In time, the proof of their true talent does shine
through.
Think
it's harder, though, for women?
It has its advantages, it has its disadvantages.
I'd like to welcome Chris and Kurt of the band Nirvana.
Hi, Ricky.
So how's it going? I mean, it's got to be, first of all, love the suit.
Thanks a lot.
Be very comfortable on planes, I think.
On planes, yeah. Well, it's a bar. It's Headbanger's Ball, so I thought I'd wear a gown.
Dress for the ball. There you go.
He wouldn't wear his tux. He didn't give me a corsage either.
No.
So you hurt his feelings.
At least I asked you out.
Yeah. There's so many evil things going on in the world. We have wars in different parts of the country, and whenever
that's good.
That's good.
It's history. It's mankind.
Whenever it gets into music, people always seem to freak out, though, even though, you know, it's like it's happening all around us.
Music, like you're playing on tonight's show, should be a little volatile. Children are growing up. They have to learn about things, and they can't learn about it just through books. They have to learn about it through experiences, and the parents should just be there maybe to guide them around and say, all right, you know, help them through it.
This man is a lunatic. He's out of his mind. Devin is from Vancouver. And he sent a tape into the label, and I had listened to, actually I received about 1,500 tapes or so for lead singers in the band, and everybody was really great, everybody sang really good and was very cute and had very nice long hair. And I like screaming, and this guy can scream. Give us, show him what I mean.
Am I allowed to scream here?
Who's gonna stop
me? Can I scream?
This is our show,
man. Can I scream
right
up to the camera?
This is our show.
And that's their ballad.